Hey guys, Lady Liberty Stacker. It is Saturday, March 30th, 2019, and what you're looking at is a package here that I got in from eBay. Came in yesterday. This was, I think it was a buy it now, but usually these are sold by auction. This is a cast iron skillet. It's a kind of a rare one. Not super rare, but rare, not very common. And I've been trying to collect these for my collection, but if I've already got one that cooks pretty well, but not this brand. So I will try to, if this is in great shape, I'll try to flip it. And after I have stripped it and restored it and seasoned it. So without further ado, let's go ahead and open it. They packaged it really well. He taped the box, put fragile on it there, taped it, put fragile there. So it's actually well packaged. The skillet isn't huge, but you put fragile, kind of the way I pack things. I put fragile or handle with care on all the angles of the box, including the underside, which he did. Make sure it's taped. Tape will give the box more, it'll give it more durability during shipping, and you need that sometimes. His only mistake is putting the shipping cost on here. It looks like he went and did this retail, but he charged me $14 for the shipping. So we made a little bit of money on the shipping, but I guess that's his right. Priority mail 2-day. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and open this guy, and I'm going to go ahead and use my Lady Liberty Stacker knife. So we're going to go ahead and open it. Cut through there like that. Love this GoPro. It makes these types of unboxing real easy to do. And yeah, I know you're not supposed to do the knife towards you, but I'm far enough away. All right, see what we got here. Put a lot of packing material in here. A lot of bags and such. Okay, he wrapped it up really good. Now, this was a skillet. This is a Griswold large block logo. And it is, yep, it's intact. He bubble wrapped it really good. So we're going to go ahead and try to undo all the tape and the bubble wrap. And it came from New York State to my state, so I had to travel a ways. And, yep, and I, you know, with this, I don't use a lot of tape on mine. You know, I use shrink wrap on mine. It's a lot easier for the buyer to get off. But, you know, that's fine. I don't think he does this full time. He does this part-time, so if you guys are thinking about a career change, you might want to think about doing it part-time, see if you like it, build up a little bit of a store, get a store going, and have a lot of features with the store, and, just sell what you're passionate about. So this one is as is, it's not restored, I need to do that myself. I'm trying not to ruin the bubble wrap, but it's really hard. Let's see what we got here. But he did a very good job packaging it, I will give him an A for that. And he's selling the skillet as is. I'm going to try to pull it out of there. Ah. Okay, see what we got here. All right, here it is. This is a number 6 Griswold. And it spins a little bit. He said it sat flat, but does have a little bit of a wobble, but we'll test it on the countertop. It is a chrome plated. You can see the chrome there. And this is seasoning, and it just will basically have to come off. You can probably use electrolysis. I don't think it said not to use electrolysis or self-cleaning oven on here. You would need to use a lye tank, which I already can set. I can set one up. That is 5 gallons of water plus 1 pound of pure lye crystals. You mix them together, and this can soak in there. It's recommended to soak something like this. At least it'll soften this up, and then put it in a vinegar soak, 60-40 vinegar water soak, to get the rest of this off. And it is very black. It's got chrome on the black side, too. But, yeah, it's just as he found it and pretty much as he advertised. And the ring, it passes the ring test. So we are going to, I'm going to pause this for just a second.
Okay, we're back on my countertop here, and you can see it. It definitely needs to be cleaned up. You can even use Easy Off Oven Cleaner if you don't feel like doing a lye tank. I can do a lye tank. Just have to wait and see what I want to do. But this is, it spins a little bit, and he said it didn't spin, so... I don't know what I'm going to do there because I bought it because he said it sat flat on the countertop. And here, I mean, it's hard to say. So I have to take a credit card to see, but I don't, we'll see what I'm going to do. I got a very good price for it. I paid $25 plus shipping, so it ended up being, for me, it was $39. $39 for a very rare Griswold. And you don't see too many chrome plated either, so... but does have a little bit of a warp there, a little bit of a warp on the bottom, so it doesn't exactly sit flat. It spins, so I'm not sure what I'm going to do. But anyway, that's why I like to actually look at them, but you never really know with the crud on it. You don't know, so it's always a gamble. But anyway, that's what I've got here.
Okay, guys, this is the original listing of the skillet, and he has the skillet here, and you just saw me unbox this. I really hate to do this to a seller, but it looks like he might have misrepresented. Now, granted, the skillet itself looked like that, and that one appears to have a little bit more rust than the one I have. Who knows? But it's $699H. $699H. And there's a closer-up on it. That's an H. And there are the pictures. And I knew that. That's not a big deal. I like to buy them like that. What concerns me about this listing, and there's the price, $25. And he says that it's a Griswold No. 6 cast iron skillet, $699H, large block logo, nickel plate. And with the nickel plate, you're not supposed to use a self-cleaning oven or, I think, electrolysis because it can discolor the skillet. So, that's not a big deal. What concerns me is this. It says, up for auction is this Griswold No. 6 cast iron skillet. The handle and top of the rim look like nickel or chrome plate. I think it's chrome, actually. It is very nice condition, being flat and even with no cracks or chips. Well, it doesn't appear to have any cracks or chips, but it wasn't flat and even. The bottom is smooth. The inside is very nice with one tiny, very lightly pitted area, the size of my tiny pinky finger. Again, pitting isn't a big deal. It really isn't. You can cook with it. You can probably see it in the photos. It is being sold as I found it, a little steel wool and season it up. The thing is, he says here, it says being flat and even. It's not flat and even. It's a spinner. It spins. You just... I'm thinking I can file item not as described. I hate to do that to a seller, but you know, he said it sat flat, and I didn't question it because that's what he said. So what do you guys think? I will pause this and I'll show you that skillet again.
Okay, guys, I'm back in the kitchen here. You can see, it's hard to show, but there is, on this side, it's even with the skillet. On this side, there is indefinitely air underneath the ruler versus the skillet. It does have a warp on it. And it definitely spins. We'll look at it again. And all you have to do is push it, and it spins around a couple of times. That's crazy. We're going to go ahead and put the camera down for just a minute. I had another skillet that didn't sit perfectly flat, but the seller was honest about it. This one here, the No. 7 Griswold, this now has 5 layers of seasoning on it, and it spins a little, but you push the handle, you push it, it spins a little, it doesn't spin all the way around. You take this skillet, you push the handle, there it goes, all the way around. Technically, you know, when it slows down almost 2 times. So, I mean, if it didn't spin, I'd definitely keep it. I think it's a great skillet. I think the chrome is neat. You don't see too many like that, but I don't like that spinning like that. It's just not good. This is excellent. I'm going to probably flip this one. And this is the one that I just put on 5 coats of seasoning, and it spins a little. No, yeah, it's no big deal. I'm going to disclose that. It has a little bit of a wobble to it. But believe it or not, I tested it yesterday with a fried egg, and I made a breakfast sandwich, and none of the residue came off of the way I season these now. None of the residue came off, and I could eat it. I actually ate it, and this thing cooks like a dream. So that's all I asked for, seller to be honest, so as I am to my buyers as much as possible. So what do you guys think? Leave it in the comment section below. Thanks again for watching. I just added this segment on because I felt like I needed to. Appreciate it. Okay, until next time.